SportsPulse. USA Today Sports Jeff Zillgitt breaks down LeBron James' dominant Game 6 performance and previews Game 7 between the Celtics and Cavaliers. USA Today Sports. The last time LeBron James lost a Game 7, it came on the road against the Boston Celtics. And here we are again, with James Cleveland Cavaliers playing the Celtics in a Game 7 at TD Garden Sunday night. Since that playoff loss to Boston in 2008. James hasn't lost a Game 7, that's 5 consecutive Game 7 victories and none larger than beating Golden State on the road for the NBA championship in 2016. His overall stats with a 5-2 record in Game 7s, 34.9 points, 9.1 rebounds and 5.1 assists per game while shooting 48.5% from the field. James has a track record of outstanding Game 7 performances, but that doesn't guarantee anything. Does James have another Game 7 road winner in him? That's a great question. The Celtics have been unbeatable at home during the postseason, 10-0 at the Garden with 3 convincing double-digit victories against the Cavs, and Cleveland has not played well in Boston. More NBA also, how do the Cavs respond without All-Star forward Kevin Love, concussion-like symptoms, who will be replaced in the starting lineup by Jeff Green? How will those young Celtics, Jason Tatum, Jaylen Brown and Terry Rozier, handle the pressure of a Game 7 with a spot in the finals on the line? We'll get those answers by around 11 p.m. ET Sunday. Here's how USA Today's NBA staff sees it. Jeff Zillgitt. If I'm rolling with one player in a Game 7 on the road, I'm rolling with LeBron James. It's difficult to pick against him in this situation. But he needs help, which he hasn't had much of in the 3 previous games this series versus Boston. J.R. Smith and Kyle Korver need to hit threes, and Larry Nance Jr. needs to play well with increased minutes because of Love's absence. And if Cleveland gets a good performance from Jeff Green, all the better. But that's a tall task. Nothing will surprise me in this game. Could go either way. Could be close. Could be a blowout, and I give the slight edge to Boston. Celtics 103, Cavs 98. Sam Amick. I learned the hard way yet again in the first round why it's such a bad idea to bet against LeBron James during his annual march to the finals. So while Boston's home dominance is certainly compelling evidence that the Celtics will move on, James' greatness and his experience on this front will get him and the Cavs through. Cavs 94, Celtics 83. Michael Singer. Given that one can be reasonably certain what type of performance Game 7 LeBron will have, I'm looking at the Cavs' role players. George Hill, Kyle Korver, J.R. Smith and Jeff Green. They haven't fared well in Boston, but if one or two of them play to their potential, that alleviates pressure on James and disrupts Brad Stevens' plan of making the other Cavs beat them. Cavs 96, Celtics 93. AJ Newharth-Kush. Nobody on the Celtics aside from Aron Baynes has been in a situation quite like this before. Win and you're in. Seems simple, right? Not when LeBron James, who has certainly been here before, is standing on the other side. The Boston crowd is ruthless, and Al Horford will be much better than he was in Game 6. But in the end, an NBA Finals without James, after all he's done to get this group to this point, just can't, and won't, happen. Cavs 105, Celtics 98.